views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of the station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio.
Good morning, everyone. You are listening to the Mary Jane Mack Show on Transformation Talk Radio. I have to say, it is a spectacular morning here in the beautiful Pacific Northwest.
Splendid day, right?
Splendid. That's our main man, Benny, here with Mary Jane. For those of you who don't know very much about Mary Jane, she is a holistic intuitive. She has an office in Issaquah, Washington, and has been doing this work since 1992. She does the TAPS program, the Accelerated Performance System. It's muscle testing your body, finding out where your deficiencies are, recommending a whole food nutrition which gets into your body, supports it, and brings it back into balance. But not only does she work with nutrition, she also works with you on your structure, spiritual, emotional. She's the whole package. And today we're going to be talking about the holistic approach to wellness. I'm your co-host, Nancy. And for those of you who have listened before, you know I'm her daughter. She is pretty spectacular. And I wouldn't be saying that if I didn't believe it. And I wouldn't be here co-hosting if I didn't believe everything she does. So, hello, Mom.
Hello. And we're happy to take your calls today.
Yes, she is here to answer your questions about yourself, a pet. She does pets. She has a lot of pets. I'm going to say mainly cats and dogs and horses. She has had some
pet birds, but that's rare.
That's very hard. Birds are hard. But, you know, I think some alpacas and goats.
Those are hard, too.
Those are hard. But for the most part, we're talking about dogs, cats, and horses.
It's not that they're hard to take care of. They're difficult. They're very fussy about taking the nutrition supplements. That's the problem.
Yeah, a little finicky, like sometimes small children are about eating certain vegetables. If you have a question for Mary Jane about yourself, a family member, give us a call at 1-800-930-2819. And we're here again with Benny, who's awesome.
Hi, ladies.
Hello,
welcome
Benny.
Back. I know last week was an enjoyable show, and we're on to another one. So, yeah, we welcome your calls if you want to join us today.
Yeah, okay. Let's rock and roll. So, our holistic approach to wellness, where do we start?
It starts simple. You know, I hear these stories all the time, and it's about I don't know what to eat, I don't know what to do. It starts simple. Today, there you could download a food list about the paleo diet. And I don't even
favorite.
Like to call it a diet. I like to call it a food program. So the paleo food program, there's a whole 30 food program. And then the one recently that's been very popular is the ketogenic diet.
What is that?
The ketogenic diet is very similar to the old Atkins diet.
So what is that?
That's more protein, low carb, no fruit, more certain vegetables that are lower carb, no starches. Most of these are no starches. On the whole 30, you actually can have potatoes, but it's more restricted. The ketogenic diet is very popular now for Alzheimer's and for any type of major health issue. To get you on track pretty quickly. Diabetes stabilizes the blood sugar very quickly. So if you want to lose weight, it's like a no-brainer. You get on this program, very easy to lose weight. And same as the Whole 30. If you follow the Whole 30 properly, any of these programs, they all improve your health. If your blood values are out of alignment and you're having testing done and everything is crazy, you know, I'll tell you, if you go to the doctor, doctor's not going to tell you or ask you. And if they do, you should keep them. But they're not going to ask you what you're eating when you have all these health issues. You could have high blood pressure. You could have heart conditions. You could have digestive issues. Rarely do they say, what are you eating? And you need to do something different. If you don't change what you're doing, inflammation, autoimmune disease, all the major things, labels that are out there, if you're eating dairy and wheat, you're just contributing to that problem. So it's you have to look at what you're doing, and processed food, of course. So when you're talking about changing what you're eating, you think organic first. If it's not all organic, it's okay. You get
fruit and veggie wash.
You get apple cider vinegar. You throw a couple tablespoons in the sink, and you throw all your vegetables in there, and you let it soak. And that lifts off all the toxins and chemicals out of your food. That's an easy way to, you should do that no matter what, because that makes a huge difference. If you're eating lettuce and certain things that are more susceptible to toxins, then you're going to be in more trouble. Like strawberries, for example, those, if they're not organic, you're just eating poison.
Well, and the other thing, a lot of the grocery stores have those bagged lettuces and things, and some are organic, some are not, but you still have to wash those. A lot of people I know don't wash those.
Yeah, you have.
You still have to wash those.
Absolutely. It comes in a bag. You still have to spray them. I either spray it with the apple cider vinegar and water mixture, or I put it in the sink and wash it. It's like, if you don't do that, people still will sometimes get diarrhea from it, because there's still something in that that's keeping it fresh for a longer period of time.
Exactly. And I can attest to the, if you don't change things, I've been battling another little cold again, thanks to my niece, little germ carrier that she is. And I'm much better, but I know that I'm the voice of reason on the show. I always believe everything in moderation. So I have my one Starbucks mocha a day. And I can honestly say that I can the dairy from the milk is affecting my cough. So it's those simple things. It's the awareness. It's kind of like I did really, really well, but just having that one a day makes a huge impact on
when you're out of balance.
When you're out of balance. So,
and if you know, it's not like you can never have those things. It's about we're talking about when you have issues going on and nothing's getting resolved, if you're not willing to look at those things and change what you're doing, then you're going to stay the same. It's like people want this miracle. What can I do? I want a pill.
I want
something.
The miracle pill.
I want something that's going to change it without me having to do anything to make it right. Unless you change what you're doing and you repeat the same thing, you're going to get the same thing. That works with the food you eat, with your emotions, with everyday life. And so it's like looking at what do you really want?
Yeah, I love that. Dr. Phil's favorite line. How's that working for you? How's that working for you? Okay, so we could take a look at what we're eating, clean it up.
Yeah, and again, remember that has to do with every part of your life. If you have autoimmune disease or cardiovascular or any kidney issues or even depression, if you're eating bad food, remember, if you're eating poor food, it lowers your vibration. And so think about, you're not in this energy state. Your body is all now in down. It's low. And that's
energy.
How you think. So it's like doing some simple things to change, get your better digestion and prevent disease.
Yeah. So again, let's take one thing and do the very best you can.
Exactly. It's pretty straightforward when you do the any of these programs like the Paleo or the Whole30 or the Ketogenic. It's the food list is right there. There's good fats on there, things that you can have. Basically, when you're looking at that list, if it's not on that list, And you're trying to really straighten out your life, you shouldn't eat it, because there's enough good food on those lists that you shouldn't feel deprived.
Well, and another thing is if your body is in balance, you aren't going to be craving all the bad foods.
Exactly.
You're not going to be craving the sugar. You're not going to be craving lots of salty things. You're not going to be craving things. So,
And then when you're doing this, remember, you don't want to go to low sodium. That's not good either.
Or low fat.
Or low fat, absolutely not. Low fat is the worst thing that ever happened in the country. When people went, everything was low fat, that's when people got the fattest. Because now you had preservatives and additives and the wrong kind of fat, and everything went the other way. Now it's fats are good, the right fats, like avocados and olives and olive oil and coconut oil. You have to look for the good fats, the MCT oil, the fats that actually help you burn fat, good butter like clarified butter or ghee or butter that's a grain-fed butter is better than the regular butter. That's what you want to go for the best. If you have the other, butter is still okay.
But just a little note, we go through a lot of butter, a lot of butter. And butter's good. I've never gained any weight from butter. I mean, I don't, like, have tons of butter, but butter on, you know, your vegetables and things. And I agree, margarine's chemicals, and that clogs your system. But if you give your body the natural whole foods, your body knows how to utilize it, break it up, and get rid of it.
And you're satisfied.
It's like
whipping cream is you. Whipping cream is on the ketogenic diet. Whipping cream is a whole cream. It's not pasteurized and watered down compared to milk. So if you're using half and half, you just should switch to regular whole cream.
I think a lot of
it's better for you.
Yeah, I think a lot of people are looking at the caloric numbers. And I think if we could get away from looking at those caloric numbers and go back to, like you said, the real organic whipping cream, use that instead of milk, creates less problems for our body. All right, time for us to take a short break. You are listening to the Mary Jane Mack Show on Transformation Talk Radio, and we'll catch you on the other side.
Relax more, feel happier, and be more confident. Do you want to have more success in your life? Dave Dodge has some easy, effective methods to help you release your anxiety, worry, fear, depression, and even physical pain. Tune in to Stress Buster Radio with Dave Dodge every second Tuesday at 1 p.m. Pacific, 4 p.m. Eastern. For more information on how Dave can help you release your stress, visit StressBusterRadio.com. Skype and phone sessions are available.
How would you like increased health and vitality? How would you like to avoid the onset of disease as well as slow the aging process? This is all possible through a simple, safe, and natural process. Every day, we are either moving toward wellness or away from wellness.
Hi, I'm Mary Jane Mack. I'd like to be your partner in achieving optimal health. Contact me now at MaryJaneMack.com or call 425-392-0659. Visit MaryJaneMack.com.
On the cutting edge of the new mainstream, Christine Upchurch is passionate about bringing together science, psychology, and spirituality in a way that can be applied to our everyday lives for true transformation. The Christine Upchurch Show, stellar conversations to illuminate your journey, engages some of the most outstanding visionaries on the planet in lively dialogue to inspire you to become that bright light you're meant to be. Join Christine every Friday at 11 a.m. Pacific Time on KKNW, AM 1150, and Transformation Talk Radio.
Did you know that all of the shows on the Transformation Radio Network are available as podcasts to stream or download?
Really?
Check us out. Go to transformationradio.fm. We have business shows, spiritual shows, energy healing shows, and pretty much everything in between. Something for everyone, guaranteed to inspire, educate, and transform. We are transforming the world one listener at a time.
Chris Stainis is a spiritual leader and healer and teaches a course on how you can transform your life through a meditation and healing system that will manifest your spirit's dreams. She manifested the Women of Wisdom Conference, the Women of Wisdom book, and this radio show. And she can show you how to change your life too. Are you ready? Visit the website and contact her at voicesofwomentoday.com. That's voicesofwomentoday.com.
What if your body and mind were the compasses to the secrets, mysteries, and magic of life? Glenna Rice, co-host of The Questionable Parent, is inviting you to access all that is possible. Glenna is a 10-year certified veteran access consciousness facilitator who offers an amazing variety of life-changing classes and workshops. Work with Glenna from anywhere with teleclasses and workshops all over the globe. To learn more and see Glenna's current schedule of events, classes, and workshops, visit GlennaRice.com.
Welcome back, everyone. Welcome back to the Mary Jane Mack Show and Transformation Talk Radio. I'm here with Benny, Mary Jane, and I am your co-host, Nancy. And today we're talking about holistic approach to wellness and where do we start. If you have a question for Mary Jane, give us a call at 1-800-930-2819. I say take advantage of this opportunity to get some answers from Mary Jane. She's amazing. You'd be surprised. Okay.
And it could be any question at all. All right, so where we're heading here, the next thing we're going to talk a little bit about is just plain old exercise. You know, people sitting there thinking, well, I don't know what to do. Well, these are just very basics.
Can I eat good food.
Can I
interject before we go to exercise?
Sure.
So when recommending the food programs, that's a great thing. But I have to say, if your digestion is off.
I'm going to get to that.
Oh, okay, sorry.
Okay. I'm going to get to that.
All right. So that was a good question.
I'm going to get to that.
That's coming.
So
you can
then,
see how this is going to go, people. Okay.
So then, exercise, but it could be simple. Walking. They have trampolines, little trampolines for the. A lot of people have them.
Just, those are dangerous.
They have them with handles on them, I'm talking about small in-house.
No, I know. That's what I'm talking about.
You know, and if you have that, that's great. It's one of the best exercises. You could dance. You could go to the gym. It doesn't matter what you do, but find something you like to do.
If you don't like it, you're not going to do it.
Yeah,
we have our materials for the show. Mary Jane did not mention this exercise, which is a shocking one. Horseback riding.
Yeah, that's a lot of exercise. Yes. Horseback riding, riding a bike. I ride a bike all the time. So it's finding what you like. It doesn't matter. And horseback riding, for heaven's sakes, just brushing and grooming horses, you get quite a bit of exercise in. And riding is great exercise. So whatever it is for you, find what you love, and then you're more likely to do it. Body's not moving, you're not moving.
And I have to say, if you're living in the Pacific Northwest, today is a beautiful day. So just start out. And you don't have to, like, you know, walk 10 miles. Start out by, if you haven't done anything in forever, start by, you know, maybe walking around the block.
Ease into it. Baby steps.
Yeah.
Nothing wrong with that.
No. Otherwise, you're not going to like it. Or there's some fabulous trails around that you can walk on, too.
Set small goals. Work to the larger one.
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly.
Very good. Mm-hmm. Walk around the block. You don't have to go in. Start simple. Start where you are. And then you'll want to go maybe on a trail when it's nice out. But just do what feels good.
And I like walking.
Yeah.
I'm a walker.
Nancy's a walker.
I love to walk.
So then you're going to do these things. And now say you got your food going, you got your exercise going, and now you're still not really feeling where you want to be. You're feeling you still have some issues. You're not getting things resolved. Your digestion might still be off, and you might find you're avoiding foods. You're not able to enjoy everything you want. Well, then that takes you to an issue that just doing your good food and exercise isn't resolving. And then that's part of what I do. I'm able to identify what's going on with you and tweak you or tune you up to get things balanced so you could move forward easily. And when we're doing that, what I do is just not nutrition and balancing your body. It's being your coach. It's being your coach for where you are, looking at where you are and where you're going and what's holding you back.
I think now might be a good time for a story from one of your horse friends.
Okay. So one of my clients who has done nutrition, she's been on my program for a long time, and she's done very well. And in the recently, within the past year or two, whenever she goes out of town to teach, she comes back and she's having more health issues than she's ever had before. Well, recently it became very, very pronounced and very serious. And I thought, now there is really something else going on here that's causing you. What's causing you here to be sick?
Every time you go out of town,
you come back worse than you went. So what's going on with you? And when I was doing her consultation, we started to talk about that and address it. And she wasn't sure what it was. So with muscle testing, your body, when you experience an emotion, that emotion, you take it in and it's stored in an organ. For example, gallbladder's resentment, liver's anger, kidney's fear, bladder's ticked off, lungs are grief, heart is sadness. So you take that emotion in and you stuff it in that organ. And then every time you experience that same emotion, that energy gets bigger and bigger in that organ. And the more energy, when it starts to overflow, that's when you present with symptoms. Now you're getting sicker, things aren't working for you, and you're stuck. The universe is trying to help you. And a lot of those things, it's the universe giving, it's like a red flag, help me, help me. And you don't know quite what to do.
Well, the universe is trying to steer you in a different direction.
Exactly.
They're trying to steer you to where you need to go. But the more you resist, the more the symptoms prevail, or things start showing up and get bigger and bigger.
Exactly. And that's the same with any disease, cancer, any disease, autoimmune disease. It doesn't matter where it is. Everything comes from a stored emotion.
So she was teaching the only reason I know this is because we know this person as...
She's a family friend.
Family friend as well. But she was teaching for a particular group is the best way to say it.
And so...
Been thinking about not teaching for that group anymore.
And I said, it seems to me that I've heard this story before. And she said, yes, I have wanted to resign before. And I said, so now tell me, what are you looking at? When do you want to do this? And she said, well, I'm thinking at the end of the year. Now, remember, she's getting sicker and sicker from doing this. Now she says, I've made commitments, so I thought I'd finish through the end of the year. And I just kind of chuckled. And I can muscle test that. And it scored absolutely no. And so I told that to her, and I said, so what's preventing you from resigning? Anybody can be replaced, whether you want to think that way or not. We could all be replaced, or someone else will step in. And she thought about it, and she thought, oh my gosh. And anyway, we talked about some other things that came up that she needed to work on and clear. And afterwards, she emailed me and said, oh my gosh, it was so obvious and clear to me after we spoke, and I actually called and canceled my commitment to do that teaching, and the first person I called to cancel, I got two calls that filled up two other of my seminars. And since then, it's been a week since that's happened, and she's canceled all those commitments, and now her schedule for this year filled up, because now she made space for the right thing to come in. And her health has changed in that short time.
So, moral of the story, things aren't going well. I'm going to do it in a year. Mary Jane scored it, tested it, said, nope, what's holding you back? She resigned from that particular position, and now she's full, and she's full
of what she wants to do.
Filled up all of her seminars of something that she absolutely loves. So that's another mysterious miracle of how the universe works.
Well, the universe is always, and I hear these stories in some way about jobs, about relationships, about being a parent. When you're doing the same thing all the time and you're not getting results and your health is changing and other things are changing, you're absolutely not in the right space. The universe is always trying to help you to be better. It doesn't take things away from you to punish you or make you feel bad. It takes it away from you because it's not where you're supposed to be. And it's opening doors for you to look at other things. When you keep that in mind, when something doesn't work out that you think was right for you, just step back and say, isn't that interesting? I thought that was right. And remember that when that's taken away, something bigger and better always comes in when you are open to it.
Yeah, if you find things are extremely hard, things aren't, difficult, paperwork's getting lost or things just keep happening and not going smoothly, take that as a sign there's something better. So let it go, surrender, and sit back and see the miracle appear before you.
It's like car accidents.
We'll talk about that. It's time for us to take a short break. You're listening to the Mary J. Mack Show on Transformation Talk Radio. Catch you on the other side.
Tune in to the hit show, Mouthing Off with Chef Rossi. Chef Rossi mouths off about different subjects in pursuit of breaking down walls and opening up your minds. She and Dr. Pat banter back and forth, taking from the headlines of the day on subjects that reach beyond what goes on in the world into your hearts. And go to theragingskillet.com to find out more and let Chef Rossi know what's on your mind.
Be you plus live your purpose equals joy. That's the motto of Unstuck Joy with Vicki Todd. Vicki believes you were born with gifts that are meant to make the world brighter. Each show will feature an art visioning journal prompt to help you create your way to soul clarity. If you're ready to get unstuck and create more joy, this show is for you. Tune in every month on Transformation Talk Radio. For more information, visit VickiWorldArt.com.
Tune in to The Truth Is Funny with Colette Steffen each Wednesday at 8 a.m. Pacific, 11 a.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. This hit show will have you thinking outside the box and riding the wave of infinite potential. Join Colette on the Higher Self Network, inspiring listeners to shine their brilliance and ensure success while roaring with laughter as they recognize the humor of the giant cosmic joke. Visit TheTruthIsFunny.com.
Are you traveling most of your day? Do you want to take Transformation Talk Radio with you anywhere you go? Well, guess what? There's an app for that. Just go to the App Store on your Apple device or the Google Play Store on your Android and search Transformation Talk Radio. Catch all of our live shows no matter where you are. Thanks for listening.
Gifted intuitive healer and spiritual teacher, Sarah Luce, brings her unique style to the hit show, Small Steps, Big Breakthrough Radio, on TransformationTalkRadio.com. Tune in each month as Sarah turns reality on end and shows us how to experience expansive results with simple yet powerful steps. Expect an enlightening bend on what you currently believe is possible. For show details and upcoming topics, visit SarahLuce.com. That's SarahLuce.com.
Are you ready for a game changer? Sarah Westall is bringing you Business Game Changers Radio. Sarah brings you leading experts, visionaries, and newsmakers who provide the best commentary on big issues and cutting-edge innovations. Sarah's 20 years as a business executive will help you think like an entrepreneur with expertise, energy, and attitude. Tune in to Business Game Changers Mondays at noon Pacific, 3 Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. Living it up in the city, got chucks on with Saint Laurent, gotta kiss myself, I'm so pretty, I'm too hot, call the police and the fireman, I'm too hot, make a dragon wanna retire, man, I'm too hot, say my name, you know who I am, I'm too hot, and my band bought that money, break it down, girls hit you hallelujah, girls hit you hallelujah.
Welcome back, everyone. You're listening to the Mary J. Mack Show and Transformation Talk Radio. Today we are talking about holistic approach to wellness. Mom's laughing at me because I kind of forgot and had to look at my cheat sheet, but that's okay. So we've talked about food plan, exercise,
emotional.
Emotions. We were touching on the emotional. And right before we went to break, you talked about car accidents.
Well, again, it's the, you know, it's, I hear these, again, hear these stories all the time, having difficult in your life, having all these other issues. And now I've had, someone says, I've had 3 accidents in the last 2 months. It's, the universe is like, do you get it? Do you get it? No, I don't get it. You're still the same, still doing the same stuff. Well, let me help you again. So every time the universe helps you, it gets louder and louder.
Well, no, not when the universe helps you. When you don't listen to the universe,
exactly,
it gets louder and louder.
Exactly. So when the universe is trying to help you and you're ignoring it.
Because you think you're doing the right thing for you or someone else in some cases, but that's not what you need to be doing.
Because when you're doing what the universe is guiding you to do, the doorway's open, everything, if the doorway closes, the other door opens, everything moves along smoothly. You may, and when you hit the little curves in the road, you just got to think about, wait a minute, maybe that's not the road I need to be on.
Well, after 3 car accidents, I would say, what?
However, in that person's mind, they're not looking at that. And that's part of what I do. It's like, you know, some people are so overwhelmed by what's going on in their life. They're in this tunnel and can't see out.
Can't see what's going on outside.
And it's like when you actually can help them see this. And the thing is, it's not even me. I'm muscle testing them for the answers. And when they realize it, it's like they could come in doom and gloom and look terrible. But they can go out with a smile on their face, feel empowered, and know that they could change things. That's what's important.
Well, and I think, like you said, a lot of times we just get stuck and we've got that tunnel vision. We don't even think of other possibilities because we're just so honed in and focused in on
doing the wrong thing.
Doing the wrong thing.
Yeah.
But in our minds, we're thinking we're doing the right thing.
Exactly.
So
exactly.
It's,
you're enabling people. You're doing things. You're in your family or relationship, girlfriends. You're like, things aren't going well. So you say, okay, we'll try it again. We'll do it again. You're doing the same thing without a bigger plan. And then you get the same results and things don't change. Again, Dr. Phil, how's that working for you?
How is that working for you?
Yeah.
And if we really look at that answer, it's not looking good.
And it's not always that. It's like, it's once you make up your mind to change it, sometimes it's not always that easy. Sometimes it could involve a little more. But if you get the right, again, sometimes you got to get more guidance. Sometimes it could be you have to talk to, I mean, in difficult cases, it could be an attorney that you need guidance from. But when you get the right guidance, then you get clarity and certainty. Then you know that what you're doing is on the right track.
And things can change quickly for the better. They don't have to take long, drawn out, you know, months, weeks, years. Things can change when everything's in balance, you're in balance, your emotions are taken care of. You know, you've got your plan, your focus. Things can change dramatically. It doesn't have to be a long, drawn-out process.
Well, and if you're a type of person that's comfortable and you don't want to go out of your comfort zone, it's like if you say, do you like change?
That would be me. No.
And if you're in a comfort zone, then you could be stuck. You have to be uncomfortable in order to change and make a difference.
Yeah.
There is no way you could stay in that cozy little spot and think that you're going to grow and be better. Or even when you're looking for a job, or you're work for a company and you have to change to another place. That all it's a challenge. So it's going to take you out of your comfort zone. But that's what's going to help you to grow, to move forward and be the person that you're meant to be.
Yeah, I'm one of those people. I'm not a good changer.
However, you do.
I do, but I'm just saying, I'm very
kind of... She can get a little resistant.
I'm resistant to change. I'm not a very good changer, but I do. And
well, in order to do more or to be better, that's even with your children, with your family, it doesn't matter. You can't just be okay all the time and be okay with what's not right and think that it's going to change on its own.
Right. Okay. So, are we going to when are we talking about if your body's not remember the nutrition question?
Well, that goes along with this whole, we're talking about mind, body, and spirit here. So, we're talking about the whole picture. You have to have the whole picture. And when people are stuck and they come in, I mean, I'm looking at what's going on with their body, what's out of balance, is their digestion off, are they in this funk because they can't think clear? They're a little depressed. Well, why is that happening? It could be your thyroid is off. It could be your brain. You've been so beat down, you can't get above it anymore and don't know what to do. So what I do is fine-tune you with the appropriate nutrition. I take the guesswork out of it. You don't when I figure out your program, it's your body telling me. So it's going to be right on target, right on track, and we can figure anything out. Whether it's a physical issue where you have inflammation, where you have ear issues, eye issues, it doesn't matter what it is. Spleen, blood.
Blood. I was having issues with my hair. Felt it was like getting thin. It's blood, thank God. So... on the proper blood stuff to get my blood up and going.
So look at what's going on in your body and then relate that to what's going on in your life. And yes, we could take care of it nutritionally, but if you don't resolve it emotionally, you will never get better. You have to look at the whole picture. And some people are very resistant to that because they don't even see how that matters.
Or some people will only go so far and not want to go any deeper to that emotion. They're like, okay, that's enough. I'm done now.
And what's exciting, though, is there are techniques that you don't have to go and drag it all up. You like when I'm doing muscle testing, there's neuroemotional technique. There's different techniques to see what's going on and to help your body release it without dragging it up and going for counseling or, you know, taking you 6 months to figure out what's going on. We could do it in minutes. And then it's like you seeing and thinking, oh, my gosh, yeah, I remember that. I can pinpoint the time, the year, when it happened, and the emotion. What was it? Fear.
And when you do that, a lot of your clients are able to come up with something right away.
Immediately. And if they don't, they'll drive home, and on the way home, they'll figure it out.
So
it's but when you get that answer from the body, what it is, it's always right on.
And it doesn't have to be a big thing. I mean, it doesn't have to be something super traumatic that happened in your life. It could be something simple and small. It could be something that, you know, somebody maybe cut you off. So it doesn't have to be a big...
Well, it could be something you thought happened that really didn't happen, but it's how you took it in at the moment. And it could be, examples would be you got fired from a job. You didn't get the promotion you wanted. Remember, when those things happen, you're not supposed to be there. And the universe might have been trying to guide you in a different direction, but you won't look at that. So now
it's that
you get fired.
To change. Yeah, so then you get fired. Now you're going to be at home all sad and depressed.
And it's not always a bad thing. It's like you have to look at the good and not be bummed out and depressed. Oh, I got fired. Well, what's going on in your – again, the question is, what's really going on in your life?
Okay.
You know, that's the joy of what I do. It's the nutrition and helping people get healthy – but it's healthy in every area. And when you can get unstuck and free yourself up and see the difference in your life and what a difference it makes for you, your family, and getting your dream. See, you know, people forget about their dream and what they really want in their life.
I think we talked about that in January. You get stuck and then you get stuck and you can't really get past, well, what is my dream? What is it? I mean, it's you're limiting yourself.
When I ask that question about what is your dream, often the answer is, oh, I don't know. I have no idea. So the homework for that is write down, if you could have anything you want in your life and there was money wasn't involved, it could be anything you want. Write that down and see what that looks like. You have to dream bigger and really, because the universe can provide anything. So start building your dream and look at what drawing a guy in your life. What does that look like? What do you want? What are the traits you want him to have? And be detailed. The more detailed you are, the more you can attract it.
Yeah, if you're looking to buy a house, and we all know that the housing market in Seattle is last time, I think it's on fire. Houses are hard to come by. But if you want a house, what is it in that house that you want? Because I know last I heard, it was kind of like, you know, there's this huge pricing war. Everybody's outbidding everybody. But if you were meant to have that house and you put in a bid, and it might not be the highest bid, but the owner of the house picks you, that's what it's all about.
Yep.
It's kind of like...
go with energy. It's all about energy.
So, yeah. So it goes back to that 52 list book and
right.
Not being trying to take the limitations off yourself. And believe me, we all get stuck. I mean, I get stuck answering some of those questions. It's like, oh, because there is no wrong answer. There is no right answer. There's no wrong answer. So be wild, be free, be crazy. And like Mary Jane says, dream big. Looking at the clock, time for us to take another quick break. You are listening to the Mary J. Mack Show on Transformation Talk Radio. Catch you on the other side.
Artie Hoffman is the hottest psychic with the warmest heart and the host of the hit show Angels and Answers. A renowned psychic, medium, spiritual life coach, and an entertaining motivational speaker, Artie has helped over 15,000 people with his amazing intuitive gifts, his passion, and his humor. Call 877-ANGEL-02 to schedule a personal reading or to have your own psychic Artie party. That's 877-ANGEL-02. And visit ArtieHoffman.com and Angels and Answers on Facebook.
Hi, this is Leslie Fontaine, and my show is Sheer Alchemy on TransformationTalkRadio.com. When we're bogged down with our emotions, the hardships that plague us in our relationships, at work, our finances, we literally can't see the higher plane where we could be operating from. Tune in to Leslie Fontaine, Sheer Alchemy on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
You, yes, you, can be the highest version of yourself. Wellness coach and natural beauty expert Dr. Agnes Renkel is on a mission to help you play the game of your life. Win in vibrancy, health, and beauty. Because you deserve it. Dr. Agnes goes beyond the limits in her personal coaching sessions to revolutionize health and wellness. Now is the time to unleash your true power. For more information, visit DrAgnesFrankel.com.
The earth is an ever-changing being. Goddess Light, shamanic healer, Bree Gibbs guides us through the ascending worlds, bringing forth knowledge and truth. As a light creator, she is here to provide new information needed at this time in our evolution. Join Bree as she shares messages from guides, spirits, ascended masters, goddesses, and others. Tune in the second and fourth Monday, 11 a.m. Pacific, and Thursdays, 1 p.m. Pacific, for Silver Gaia Radio.
How would you like to release your stress and let go of your anxiety, fear, depression, or even physical pain? How would you like to feel more relaxed, more confident, and experience more success in all areas of your life? Dave Dodge from Stress Buster Radio has a number of cutting-edge methods that will help you do just that. For more information on how Dave can help you release stress, visit StressBusterRadio.com. Skype and phone sessions available.
Miss any shows during the week?
No!
Don't worry, we've got you covered. With the free Transformation Talk Radio app, you'll have access to all of the past week's shows in the palm of your hand.
Yes!
Tune in to Transformation Talk Radio anywhere you go with our free app for any of your devices. Check out our app in the App Store and Google Play Store today.
Welcome back, everyone. Welcome back to the Mary Jane Mack Show on Transformation Talk Radio. I'm your co-host, Nancy, here with Mary Jane and the always awesome Benny.
Oh, thank you very much. I appreciate that.
You're so special.
We love Benny.
We do love Benny.
Big heart stretching back to you. Big heart. Big heart.
Good.
And I have to say, there are a lot of people who love Benny, because when I pop into Mary Jane's office, they're like, oh, my God, you're Nancy on the radio show. I'm like, yes. And they always ask about Benny.
For a minute, I'm like, and forget about you. What about Benny? No, I'm just joking. I'm kidding.
No, that's all
you should bring in like a paper sign for me, like a little picture
of me,
on a stick. Like, look, Benny's with us.
I have a picture of you, actually,
on my
phone.
Feel free to use it.
Yeah, okay. We'll do that. All right, go to the phones.
Sure. Well, let's take Pat calling in from New York. Hello, Pat. You have a question for us?
Yeah, I heard you talking about all kinds of emotional problems that can cause physical and life
issues.
Issues. And I've had a lot of medical issues. Mostly I have inflammation, bladder, prostate, stomach, intestines. And I've been seeing that I had some, things I was stuck with in my life, I turned to, releasing the negativity using a technique called the Sedona method or the release technique. And I've done a lot of meditation using this technique, and I've dumped just truckloads of emotional garbage. But still, I am having these medical problems. And lately I've been, some of the medical experts, for example, have thought that my problem was isolation and physical inactivity. And,
Pat, how old are you?
62.
Okay. So, and how long have you had the problems?
Well, they've been creeping up for 20 years. I mean, a doctor of traditional Chinese medicine kind of saved my life. I was really heading often he, with acupuncture and all that stuff, kind of got me back on the track, but still, like, I kind of plateaued and I got stuck. And
okay, so what happened to you when you were, 32? You were 32? Think about where you were. Where did you live?
I lived in the same town, 32. I moved to a different town and a couple of different towns.
Were you single or married?
Single.
Okay.
I've never been married.
Okay. So you were 32, and What about your parents?
I mean, the problems weren't that bad. I mean, but you
it's
know,
all
this
relative.
When you taste...
It's all relative.
Yeah.
Yeah. So what I get is something the first time that whatever it is started to happen was when you were 32, and it was you, the son of the father. So was your dad alive at that time?
Yes.
Was there anything that happened with your dad, your fear for your dad at that time?
No.
Was
well,
he
there's
sick?
Been a lot of issues with my dad from when I was very young, but not at that point.
Okay, this was something at 32, your fear over your dad, and that's what I pick up is what some of this, where this all started. So just think about that and see what pops into you. Remember, it could be fear of worrying about your dad being sick, fear over your dad being okay, fear over not liking what your dad said. It could be anything.
Doesn't have to be huge.
It doesn't have to be huge, but that's what I get. And then from what you said, this all started like 10 years after that. But something happened at that time that started to cause all this.
Around that time is when two incidents. I broke up with a girlfriend at about 27, 28, and then my mother got ill.
When you were 32?
My mother died, actually. I can't get the dates all straight, but sometime after that, you know, probably when I was 34, he died.
Who died? Your mother?
Dad.
My mother. My dad died at 34. My mother looked like she was going to die. She ended up living another, 10 years. My father died unexpectedly when I was about 34.
Okay.
So maybe it could be, I'm just going to throw this out there because I'm not the professional. Maybe it could be fear over your father being alone since your mother was ill.
Or was your father sick at all?
Divorced when I was 5.
Yeah. Anyway, it still is when you were 32, your fear over your dad, it could be, was your dad getting sick? Just think about it. There was something there that stirred you up. So that's what I'm picking up that's going on with you today is where it started.
The emotional aspect.
The emotional part of it. So just take that because there's still, you've got 80% of it with what work you've done. There's another 20% you haven't gotten. So that's pretty good. So now that you know that, because otherwise you wouldn't be calling. So look at that and see what you come up with and just kind of go back to that time. Okay, Pat?
Okay.
All right, Pat. And then to get to your other issues, go ahead and give Mary Jane's office a call at 888-777-4232.
We could help you with that bladder and your other issues to help clean that up.
And then possibly you could, if something does pop in with this 32 and your father, you could take care of it.
Exactly.
So thank you very much, Pat.
Cool. And let's try Deanne from Bellevue very quickly, if you don't mind. She has a question about her 8-year-old granddaughter, I believe. Yes, Deanne?
Hi, Deanne. How are you?
Hi, Mary Jane.
Hi, Deanne. Yeah.
How are you?
I'm good.
I'll be really brief. What I wanted to ask about is my 8-year-old granddaughter. And she has some attention issues in school. She's a really, really bright kid and really adorable and sweet and doesn't seem to have any real problems. I think, personally, there's a little ADHD going on, and I think it's her diet. Because I tell her sugar is her enemy, but that's just me.
Right, right.
And so my question to you is, would it be a good idea to bring her in for a session with you and maybe we could get to the bottom of what's going on with her?
I think that would be the simplest way to do it. I think that she really is not too far off, might have a little digestive issues, but we could tune up the brain a little bit, and it would be very simple. The beauty about working with kids is they change quickly, and it doesn't take a lot. So that would be great. I'd love to see her.
You know, I've been meaning to ask you in the last couple times I've been in, and I keep forgetting because I'm so old, But in the meantime, it just occurred to me today when I heard you that I've been meaning to call the office and ask. I thought this was an excellent opportunity. So thank you for that, and I'll make an appointment for her.
You're welcome. And Deanne, you are one of the most wonderful people I know and sharpest and smartest. So,
well, you know what? I just always think the same thing about you.
Oh, thank you.
Ladies, thank you.
See you soon.
And what I will say is thank you for so much help for me over the years. I don't know what I'd do without you.
Oh,
I appreciate you.
Well,
thank you. Love you.
Thank you, Deanne. All right. For those of you who would like to make an appointment with Mary Jane, give her office a call at 888-777-4232. And some of you may know this, you don't have to live in the Pacific Northwest to have an appointment with Mary Jane. She does a lot of phone consultations. Mary Jane, a few last words.
We just take in mind what we talked about today and dream your dream and make it big. You have every opportunity to live the life you want. It's all up to you. And if you keep doing the same thing and don't get a change, get out of that rut. Give us a call. I'm here for you. I'm happy to help you with your health issues, with your physical issues, and your entire package, and can direct you in the right direction to make a difference.
I always like to joke with her. I'm like, geez, you're performing all these miracles with your people. I'm looking for my own miracle here. What's not happening? So,
and I say, what do you want to happen?
Exactly. So anyway, she really does make miracles happen. So give her office a call at 888-777-4232. Thank you, everyone, for listening. And thank you, Benny, for being awesome. And I hope everybody has a fantastic day. We'll see you next month. I'm such a baby, yeah, the dolphins make me cry.